Welcome to Desktop Deployment Essentials, our new series to help you prepare for your shift to Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus. In the next few minutes, I'm going to walk you through the first step in our recommended deployment process wheel by covering what you need to know about application and hardware compatibility. And along the way, I'm going to show you the tools and options you have to discover your devices and applications and prepare them for deployment to Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus. Now, if you've been in the industry for a while, the good news here is that preparing for the shift is now much easier. You might remember from your last major desktop deployment, the biggest hurdle to overcome was application and hardware compatibility. Now that for the most part goes away with the majority of compatibility issues being resolved. A few notable things made this possible. Technologies like file and registry virtualization solve for DLL conflicts. It's now common practice for applications to not require elevation of privilege, and built-in compatibility modes and shimming remove the problem of hard-coded version checks. This means that just about any application written in the past 10 years will be compatible with Windows 10. Now, on the Office side, extensibility options for COM add-ins and macros have remained more or less static since Office 2010. Even add-ins predating Office 2010 will typically work without modification. That said, depending on the size and age of your organization, you'll still want to perform some level of testing and validation against hardware and software components as part of your desktop deployment project. Now, this is really a four-step process, starting with inventory, then prioritization, testing, and finally remediating app and hardware compatibility. To generate an inventory of managed PCs along with apps running on those PCs, you may currently be using things like System Center Configuration Manager inventory reporting. With Windows 10, we introduced a new intelligence solution available with your Windows license called Windows Analytics Upgrade Readiness. This is our recommended tool. And if you're not familiar with Windows Analytics, it's a cloud service that uses an agentless process to inventory the computers, applications, and Office add-ins across your desktop estate. Now, it works by tapping into compatibility information and telemetry for both applications and drivers used as part of Microsoft's upgrade cycles for hundreds of millions of consumer PCs and returns a detailed assessment of driver and app compatibility issues. Now, these are issues that might block your upgrade, and we give you links to suggested fixes that are known to Microsoft. Windows Analytics can also discover highly visited internet sites, browser-based apps, and internet locations for compatibility testing later. It's also straightforward to use. A visual workflow guides you from pilot to production deployment, and you can even export data from Windows Analytics to most software deployment tools, including System Center Configuration Manager. So there you can target PCs directly to build collections as those PCs become ready for deployment. And one more thing to note, once you've made the shift to Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus, the tool helps you keep track of your deployment of semi-annual feature updates so you can stay current. So now with your inventory ready, let's look at prioritizing the most common apps and hardware used in your organization. Perhaps the most time-saving role that Windows Analytics serves is in helping you to quickly see what to focus on so that you can quickly unblock as many PCs as possible for deployment. For example, here you'll see discovered apps listed. You can get insights to help you prioritize, and in most cases, you won't need to test every app that's discovered. For example, if one or two people have an app installed, that app might not be worth the effort, or you can decide to replace it with a more popular app from your inventory. Now let's move on to testing. In most cases, applications and drivers and add-ins inventoried will work as is, and if not, Windows Analytics will often provide you with information on where to find updated versions if you need them. And for browser-based app compatibility, note that Microsoft Edge doesn't support ActiveX controls, browser helper objects, VBScript, or other legacy technologies. These are all cases that Windows Analytics also helps you identify. And if you have websites or web apps that still use this technology and need to run in Internet Explorer, you can add them to the Enterprise Mode Site List Manager so they run in IE. Additionally, for your move to Office 365 ProPlus, you can use the Readiness Toolkit for Office to test add-ins and VBA macros, which can help you identify compatibility issues with Office. Now, the final phase of device and app readiness is to remediate. Here, you'll want to collect the required software and driver packages, and you're going to use those packages to supersede or update older versions of those apps and drivers as part of your deployment process. As you work through the list, you'll see that more and more PCs become ready for deployment, meaning that both the drivers and apps on those PCs are noted as compatible with the version of Windows 10 that you're targeting for your deployment. So that covers our four-step process. And to set up Windows Analytics, to inventory and prioritize device and app readiness, you can check out our guidance at the link shown. And just a few tips here. You're going to need to set up an Azure subscription and include an Azure Log Analytics workspace. Once you have a Windows Analytics Upgrade Readiness service running, you can enroll any internet-connected Windows 7 Service Pack 1 or newer device via group policy settings. Remember, as you work through your list, you can continually phase your deployment as more and more PCs become ready. Now, this means that you can work in parallel on other steps on the deployment process wheel. In fact, up next, we're going to explore deployment-related considerations for networking and directory services. And to learn more, visit our Modern Desktop Deployment Center and keep following our Desktop Deployment Essentials series here on Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching.